Here in Philadelphia, Citizens Bank Park, we've got a perfect day for baseball. It's the Arizona Diamondbacks taking on the Philadelphia Phillies. First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about ready to roll here. Now the starting pitcher in this one, Zach Wheeler. Always a treat to watch one of the best starters in the sport singing.
Well, the hammer is in effect, and he sets it up so nicely because of the velocity on the fastball. We'll elevate that and then break you off when he's ahead in the count. What I love about him, you get into the later innings of the ball game, and the velocity seems to go up.
Now here is Jake McCarthy. And a bunt towards third. Bare hand scoop. Got him. Nice play. Time to take a look at the Diamondbacks lineup. A tough challenge in this one. An excellent arm on the mound. Singy, they're going to have to capitalize on their opportunities.
Yeah, and they're not going to get a whole lot if he pitches the way that he's capable of pitching. So, you know, be ready to swing from the first pitch. You get something straight, man, you better turn on it.
Here's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. He has consistently been one of the best in the sport against lefties, and yet the righties give him trouble. You know, you don't want to be labeled as that guy, but the numbers say what they say. One down, base is empty. In the air, right field, pretty well struck. Castellanos ranges back. Out of here. He shoots one out to right, and that gives him a lead. It's 1-0.
You can't ask for a better start than hitting a home run in your first at bat to give your team the lead. So many times a sinker inside is a foul ball off the ankle for the batter. But that time he did a really nice job of staying inside the pitch and getting through.
Base is empty, one away. An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. That one ripped. And it banks off the top of the wall. Throws to second. And he starts his afternoon off right with a double.
Nice line drive to the pole side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
And now it's Christian Walker. And the pitch. Hard ground ball, base knock. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out.
That is it. The designated hitter.
So one out with two aboard. Next to hit for Arizona, Jock Peterson. And the righty deals. Grounder might be two. There's one. And that's two. D-backs get one on the solo jack. It's an early 1-0 lead. Back after this on the show. Back here in Philadelphia, and on the hill today, Jordan Montgomery.
Well, that 12-6 curveball explodes out of the hand, and because he's able to throw the high fastball at the top of the strike zone for a strike, hitters commit to that pitch, and before they know it, they're swinging over the top of that curveball.
Bottom of the first, leading off, Kyle Schwarber.
The designated hitter, Kyle Schwarber.
The pitch. Liner, base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
Hooked around that pitch on the outside, but he was still able to square it up pretty nicely, and that takes quick, strong wrist to pull that off.
Here's Nicholas Castellanos. The pitch. And he swings through that one. Schwarber gets his lead at first with nobody out. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. And now the lefty keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The pitch. Right back to the mound. Could be an easy two. Over to Perdomo. That's one. To Walker, and that's two.
I think the at-bat right there, and usually the hitter wins that battle after seeing so many pitches, but instead, the exact opposite, or maybe even worse than that, grounds into a double play. Tough at-bat to swallow.
Here's Harper now. The pitch. That misses. And that's ball two.
Two balls, one strike.
Lifted in the air, right center field. And that is that. Back here, Citizens Bank Park. Now, here is Eugenio Suarez. And another ball. Next offering in there for a strike. And the count is 2-2. Ricky Holiday, our umpire behind the dish, known as pretty fair umpire for both hitters and pitchers.
Yeah, I think that's right, Boo. There is a little inconsistency on the corners of the plate. You can't always be sure how it's going to go with those borderline pitches as the game progresses.
Gets a piece and stays alive. Lined into left center, base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Next up for the Diamondbacks, Gabriel Moreno. Runner on the goal. Hard on the ground to first. Harper steps on the bag. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion.
The center field number seven, Corbin.
This is Corbin Carroll. One out, the runner at second. Here at the top of the second. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. And Chris, that's a way to neutralize his speed by keeping him off base.
And the defense breathes a sigh of relief because he puts pressure on everyone if he can put the ball in play. But that's how you do it. Keep him off balance, get him out of there, and deal with the next guy.
Now the batter now, Geraldo Perdomo. And a good eye there. Next offering upstairs.
Love how this guy grinds out at bats. I mean, he's down there at the bottom of the lineup in the nine hole, but he's worked himself into a really good hitter's count trying to pick up a two-out RBI.
Swing and a miss. And the count is filled up.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
Three. And a swing and a miss. And that will end the inning. One left for the Diamondbacks. But they still lead it 1-0. Back here in Philadelphia, bottom of the second. And now it's Alec Bohm. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Outside. The count now 2-2. And a pitch. Stays alive. Here comes a pitch. And there's a ball. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. At the belt and fires. This ball's chopped on the ground. Gathers and throws to first. So it was a long battle at the plate, but they still managed to get the out.
Yeah, he looked a little tentative on that swing, almost like he didn't get pitch recognition and tried to slow his bat down just to make contact. I'd rather see a guy swing through it instead of making weak contact and putting it in play, have another pitch where maybe he can drive out of the ballpark.
Fouled off. He was late. One down. Phillies down a run.
Three.
Struck him out swinging. Couldn't catch up to the heater. And here is Sosa to the plate. And a pitch. And a pop-up. Right side. Foul territory. He's got it. And that'll end the inning. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. And it remains 1-0. And we're back onto the third inning. Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Jake McCarthy. Here's a 1-1. That one the other way. Takes it in for the out.
It's never fun going back to the dugout after hitting a line drive that finds a glove, but you will get some high fives. You know, when you make great contact, you feel like you've done everything right. But in this game of baseball, not everything is in your control.
And that's off the inside edge. 2-1. One out, base is empty. The wind and the pitch. Fights it off, he'll see another.
Pitcher having a pretty tough time getting that swing and miss. Third foul ball in a row.
One down, base is empty. Out to short, and it's through for a hit.
The batter, second base, Ketel.
One down, Ketel Marte up to the plate. Here's a 1-1. Swing and a foul straight back. Kicks and fires. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Dahl moving under it. They got it for out number two.
Up next to the Diamondbacks, The first baseman, Christian.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Christian Walker. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one fouled off. Gurriel off of first with two away. And another ball.
Good purpose pitch right there. Trying to tease him, get him to raise his sights, pop something up, and make it an easy out.
Now all even up. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Had him out front for strike three. One left for Arizona, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Back at Citizens Bank Park. Set for the bottom of the third. Here's the left fielder, David Dahl. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2. This one in the air. Suarez under it. One down.
Batting it. The catcher.
And now for the Phillies, Garrett Stubbs. The 1-1 is fouled off. And he deals. That's hard hit in the line. He's got it. And there's two away.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Pitch and a swing and a miss, and that's that. Phillies down in order, still behind by a count of 1-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Jock Peterson. And a 1-1. Swings through that one for strike two.
This guy's sink has so much drop on it. It's almost like a split finger fastball. Instead of just weak contact and balls on the ground, he gets swings and misses.
Righty delivers. Out towards right center. That's well struck. Castellanos ranges back. And out of here. And they add on. It's 2-0.
Pitch he wanted to hit, spent on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Hey, Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. Big swing and a miss.
Boy, just got it deleted. You give up that leadoff home run. Go back to work. Focus on this next batter.
Righty to the plate. And another ball. Chopped left side. Boom. Fires across the diamond. They go 5-3 for the first out as the third baseman makes the play from the shortstop spot in the shift. Here's the catcher, Gabriel Moreno. The 1-1. That one pushed foul. The 1-2. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Stubbs hauls it in for the out. Two down.
The center fielder, number 7, Corbin Carroll.
Two outs, base is empty. Corbin Carroll stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. And it's 2-0. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back here in Philadelphia, here's a big power threat. Kyle Schwarber. Kyle Schwarber. 3-1 now. Lined, and that's a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
The bat. Dominant the performance right for him today, but just two hits allowed. No runs across either, and he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced. So I don't think this hit is going to knock him off his stride too much.
Nick Castellanos at the plate now. The pitch. And a count 1-2. And that's downstairs and outside. Hardliner. Drops into the glove.
Now back, the first baseman, Bryce Harper.
Here's Bryce Harper.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
The Diamondbacks up by 2. We're here at the bottom of the 4th. And another ball. Close, but called a ball. And now 3-1. Line drive, and that's a base hit to right. They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away.
Now back.
That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and ripped it into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
Alec Bohm stands in for the Phillies. And strike 2.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning-ending double play, Boo.
1 out, runners at first and second. that one down the line, and it's through for a hit. Here comes Schwarber around third. He'll score easily, and now they trail by one. Throw comes in and holds the runner at third. They're at the corners now with still only one away.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine, another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. This is Bryson Stott. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. Slap the other way, foul.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
1-2 here. Got him looking. Huge strikeout there.
Well, they're pretty much giving it to him right there. Playing the infield back. All you're looking for on offense is a simple ground ball. You got a tie ball game. Not sure what he was thinking up there. Strikeout looking is the last thing you want to see. Now you got to hope the next guy can pick you up and come through with a big two-out hit.
Edmundo Sosa now at the plate. Two on, two outs. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Good job at damage control right there.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
Back here, Citizens Bank Park, ready now for the fifth inning. And now the shortstop, Geraldo Perdomo. Next offered in there for a strike. And now it's 3-2. Ground ball to the right side. Sneaks through, base hit. And that turns the lineup over.
The right fielder, number 31,
Jake McCarthy stands in now for the Diamondbacks. There goes the runner. And he can't come up with it. To first, and he just gets it there in time. One away. And it's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. In there for a strike at the bottom of the zone. Runner at second here, one gone. Righty deals. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. And the right-hander deals. And that one upstairs.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Man at second. Runs it up to 96 to record the punch out.
Get him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
Here's Ketel Marte. The pitch. That one's in there, and a count 1-2. Runner at second, two down, and we're at the top of the fifth. The next offering misses. Two balls, two strikes. Yeah. And on second, two down. And a ground ball to first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. One left for the Diamondbacks, but they still lead it 2-1. Back here in Philadelphia, bottom of the inning. Now the left fielder, David Dahl.
Philly. No left fielder. David Dahl.
Chopped on the ground. And he handles it himself for the out.
Now batting. Catcher. Get ready. Stubbs.
So digging in now for Philadelphia, Garrett Stubbs.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is that I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Wurmbrunner into the outfield for a knock. So a man aboard now with one away.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Johan Rojas. Slow roller to third. Off balance beat, there's one. Throw to first, but he beat it.
Tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
So the Philly batting order turns over. Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here. Move over to first, trying to keep him close.
Base runner with a one-way lead right there. All he's trying to do is get a look at the pitcher's move. Had no intent of stealing on that pitch.
Two outs. Second, headed for third, headed for the plate. He scores to tie it up. It's 2-2. Second here with two away, and digging in for Philadelphia, Nick Castellanos. Turned on, but foul wide of third. That one not close, and it's 2-2. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Number 49 getting ready to go. Martinez getting cranked up as well. Trying to keep this a 2-2 game. Last half of inning number 5. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. The pitch. Swings and misses. Struck him out.
He's in a tough spot, had to make a great pitch, did it, got the strikeout, gets out of the jam. Clearly, he's happy with those results.
And we're back. And here's the first baseman, Christian Walker. Kicks and deals. Fought off foul.
You see him trying to pull that inside pitch right there, and that's not the kind of approach that you want to have. Even if you do get to it, it's going to be very difficult to keep it fair. You're just going to make it a long strike at best. You have to be able to stay within the baseball on the inside of that path to it, and that way, if you're a little quick,
the ball gets hit hard somewhere and it's not foul.
And now Jack Peterson is a 1-1. Line drive. Dives, but it's off his glove. Base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
He was all over that one. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Man at first with one gone. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. Sosa to second. There's one, and that's two.
To hit it exactly where he wanted. That textbook 6-4-3 double play gets out of the jam and back in the dugout.
Number 49 gets the call from the pen.
Now pitching for Arizona, number 49.
Three, four, five due up for the home team. And now here is Harper.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
Left-hand hitter waits. Right side. Marte throws to first. One away, bottom of the sixth.
Good two-seam action right there, running away from the batter. Rolled over it, got the ground out.
Alec Bohm stands in for the Phillies. All tied up here in the bottom of the sixth. That's to third. Oh, a great grab on the dive. Gathers and throws, and that's a great play for the out.
To his left, fully extended there in front of the shortstop to make the grab. Up with it, then a strong, accurate throw across the diamond to complete this highlight play.
And stepping in is the speedy Bryson Stott. Right-handed reliever. Up and in. Now two balls and a strike. Two out, space is empty. Just missed. The corner, three balls, okay. Two strikes. And here comes. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Down quickly go the Phillies. And this game is still tied at 2-2. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Orion Kerkering. Now the D-backs catcher, Gabriel Moreno.
The catcher, number 14, Gabriel Moreno.
Ball to strike, the pitch. And another ball. The 2-1. Right through there for a strike.
No need to offer that pitch until you get to two strikes. It's just a low percentage of success when you want to try to go after that down and away pitch.
Cut out and miss. Struck him out. One out.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there. At least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
And now the center fielder, Corbin Carroll. And he lays down a bunt. And he picks it up and he'll put it in his pocket. And a 1-2. Way inside, gets out of the way. Swing and a miss. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees.
Chance to strike out the side now. You talk about the benefits, the advantages of relievers who can come in and get the swing and miss, whether it's inherited runners or maybe a little jam that they get into themselves. Knowing that they can miss the bat, tell you what, that's huge and can change the ballgame.
So two down now, and here is Geraldo Perdomo. Next offering is in for a strike. Two down, nobody on. Here in the top half of inning number seven. And now 2-2. On the ground at first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Nothing doing for Arizona. Score remains 2-2. Set for the last half of the seventh. Now it's the shortstop, Edmundo Sosa. Ripped on a line, makes the grab on the run, and there's one down.
Great swing of the bat right there, trying to get on as that go-ahead run. He just wasn't able to find a hole.
And now for the Phillies, David Dahl. That just misses, and the count is 3-1. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Gurriel handles the chance, and there's two down.
Now catcher.
Here's the Phillies catcher, Garrett Stubbs. Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
It might be time to choke up a little bit, get that front foot down early, maybe even just spread out. He's really late right now.
Swing and a ball popped up. Makes the play, and it's out number three. Phillies go down quietly in the inning. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. At Citizens Bank Park for the top of the eighth. Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Jake McCarthy. The wind of the pitch. And a count 1-2.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
And another ball. And that one a little below the knees. And a full count now.
Really close pitch down around the knees there. And you could see him asking where it missed. Probably doesn't agree, but it appears he's ready to move on to the next pitch.
Ground ball up the middle. Lays out. Oh, it's off his glove. He decides to hold on to it, and they come away without an out.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. And now let's see if they force some action with good wheels on the bases.
Here's Gurriel.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
And a pinch. Outside.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get in the scoring position.
With the go-ahead run at first, and we're in the top of the eighth. Wouldn't chase that time.
So here we go. Base runner at first could be running on the pitch. He's got good enough speed to steal the bag to get in scoring position, even if it's a swing and miss at the plate.
3-2. To short, could be two. Flips for one. Plenty of time at first. That's a double play.
Very smooth on the feet. The second right there. You've got to love that glove toss, Boog. You know, sometimes people think these guys are being a little flashy, but it actually can make more sense to do that than try to make a full transfer. And you got to remember, these guys work on that play all the time, so it's in their back pocket whenever they need it.
Just off the outside edge. Two down, nobody on. And that one almost hit him. In the air, left field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that's the third out. And welcome back to the ballpark. On to the bottom of the eighth. So digging in now for Philadelphia, Johan Rojas. Outside low. 2-1. In there for a strike at the top of the zone. Still 2-2 after the foul ball.
Threw open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his back down just enough to make contact with that pitch. Keep the at-bat alive.
The 2-2. Slider misses outside. Kyle Schwarber on deck for the Phillies. Swing and a drive. Deep left field. Gurriel on the move, racing back. Get out of town. He sends a rocket to left. It's 3-2. Listen to these fans.
This place is absolutely buzzing right now. You can feel the energy all the way up here in our broadcast booth.
Man, he just barely got that one out of here. And you've got to love the effort and laugh to try and bring it back. What a good shot. He just couldn't quite pull it off. It would have been a stunner if he did.
Back to the top of the lineup. And here's the Phillies leadoff man, Kyle Schwarber.
Two balls.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Nobody on, nobody out. Here the bottom half of the eighth inning. Next offering way off the plate.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
Dives and he can't hang on. The throw is still in time, and they come away with an out after a tricky start to the play.
Great job by the second baseman right there. Quick reaction to dive, knock that ball down, and big leaguers just don't panic, not the good ones. He gets up, makes the play, really good throw over to first base. That's the kind of composure that you want to see from a guy in that position.
And digging in for Philadelphia, Nick Castellanos. The pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Here comes a pitch. And another ball.
Doubled up on the slider away. Two-seamer here. Just watch and see.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air. Left field pretty well struck. That's back there. And that ball is out of here. It's their second home run of the inning. And they add a run. It's 4-2.
Looks like this guy was looking out over the plate, but he was ready to turn on the inside fastball. So direct to the pitch, absolutely blasted out of this ballpark.
So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, Joe Mantiply.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Bryce Harper to the plate. And the pitch. Good eye in that spot. Left-hand batter waits. And a foul ball. Still only one out here in the inning. Goes down looking.
This guy will throw any pitch in any count. 3-2. He goes off speed. Gets the out.
Allen. Ball.
Two outs, base is empty. Alec Bohm stands in for the Phillies. That misses the zone, and a count 2-1. Two outs. Lined into right. Makes the catch. And that is that. But two round trippers in this inning. The long ball was working. Last chance coming up for the D-backs. Now, and on the mound, the closer, Jose Alvarado.
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down wins. So this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
And now the lefty. Walker checks his swing. Now an appeal to first. He did not go around. Strikeout for the first out here in the ninth.
Not the best location with the fastball on strike three, but when you're pumping high 90s, you'll get away with some of those, more margin for error. You know, the fastball becomes such a huge strikeout pitch in the sport. And I think a lot of it has to do with all the attention and emphasis on improved spin rates. These fastballs are just exploding out of the pitcher's hands and jumping through the zone.
And he grounds one to the right side. Stott over to first in time. And Arizona with just one out left.
Now batting. Third baseman. Eugenio.
Now the third baseman. Eugenio Suarez. The D-backs down by a pair here at the top of the ninth. That's in for a strike at 95. And it's 1-2.
Well, this was a tightly played game. Got a little of everything. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching and defense in certain spots. Definitely a fun one to watch.
And your final, 4-2. The Phillies hang on to win it. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Schaumburg. Thanks for joining us.
final line for this afternoon. First for the victorious Philadelphia Phillies. Four runs on 8 hits. No errors. They left 3 runs.